In this video, we're looking at hardware configurations for running SolidWorks, CATIA, and other Dassault Systems solutions. Whether you're wondering if your current system is up to scratch for your requirements, or purchasing a new machine, we'll look at all the key components from processors and graphics cards to RAM and data storage. At the end of the video, you'll have a better idea of where you should and where you should not invest your money. Workstations offer a wide variety of options, which can make it tricky to get the specification right, and it's even possible to spend more money and potentially get worse performance. For instance, buying a system with many but slower cores may make core CAD modeling and some other tasks even slower. We've seen this time and time again. With the best of intentions, it's possible to specify a workstation that is either poor value for money or plain wrong for the task. So let us demystify this for you and make sure you get the right specification for your requirements. Alongside your use case in terms of software complexity and data sets, you should also consider how important mobility is to you. Historically, desktops were the go-to machines for CAD, but now desktops and mobile workstations can achieve very similar levels of performance, and laptops are becoming the preferred choice for many of our customers, primarily due to the increase in remote and hybrid working. Desktop workstations do still offer more power with their increased space for cooling, particularly when workloads will run for hours rather than seconds or minutes. So the questions really are, how much do you value portability and how demanding are your workflows? We'll walk you through our recommendations for different workflows, breaking it down into the core components and how those affect different use cases. Let's start with your processor or CPU. And some good news to start, it's gotten a lot easier to advise on since 2022. The latest Intel CPUs used in workstations provide a mix of fast, single-threaded performance and up to 16 cores for multi-threaded workloads. So our recommended systems with Intel's 12th generation CPUs offer the best CAD and computer-aided engineering workflow performance in tools such as simulation. Each generation of CPU will do more work per gigahertz, so comparing even a 3 to 5 year old CPU running at similar speeds, the newer CPU will far outperform the older one from our testing. The main specs to be looking at when talking about CPUs are the speed rated in gigahertz, number of cores, and the power rating of the processor. Now about those cores, the best advice for CAD work is mainly to focus on the maximum turbo boost speed and the power rating of the CPU. The system with a high turbo boost speed will perform well for typically light threaded CAD workflows, and those with a higher power rating are likely to sustain that speed for longer. While developers continue to look for any opportunities to utilize multiple cores, the nature of parametric CAD requires one task or feature to be completed before the next. Therefore, most of the time you will see just 1 to 2 cores used by SolidWorks. There are, however, exceptions to this, such as drawings when multiple cores can be used to generate or rebuild different views, or certain assembly rebuild tasks. The other big exception are workloads such as simulation and CPU-based rendering tools. The majority of simulation workflows can benefit to some degree from more cores, and while that benefit will vary dependent on factors such as complexity, study and solver type, the golden rule is to not compromise the speed of those cores too much. In our testing to date, going from 16 fast cores to 18, 24, even more cores may see no benefit or even a regression in performance, especially if those cores are based on older technology. Comparing to a typical workstation from 2018 that would feature just 4 to 6 cores, now that number is 12 to 16, even in laptops. And those same CPUs offer the fast, lightly threaded performance preferred for core CAD workflows. It really is the best of both worlds currently. Often RAM is the first thing we hear from CAD users as the go-to upgrade when the machine isn't performing well. But it isn't always the correct fix, as more RAM will only benefit you if you're running out of RAM in the first place. The best advice we can offer here is to test your current workflows to see their RAM utilization. Buy enough for that with a bit of headroom on top. If possible, when buying new, leave spare memory slots that can be used at a later stage. With ever-growing demands from other Windows applications, too little can result in needing to close other applications to run demanding ones like SolidWorks. so we recommend 32 gigabytes as the sweet spot for most users, with 64 recommended for those dealing with the most complex datasets or running multiple demanding workflows. More than this is really only for very niche applications. For simulation, we also recommend error code correcting or ECC RAM, which can improve stability. Note that with no mainstream Xeon CPUs in the newer generation machines, currently these features are now supported by Intel's 12th generation and newer core CPUs in workstation platforms only. Storage-wise, nowadays pretty much every system will come with a solid-state drive rather than older mechanical hard drives. The latest M2 PCIe Gen 4 drives are not significantly more expensive than other options out there, so we'd recommend these drives. Size-wise, due to the amount needed for operating systems and programs, we would recommend a minimum of 512GB in an SSD, with 1TB or more if you're extensively using simulation or rendering tools which can generate significantly larger datasets than typical CAD work. Equal to the CPU in terms of importance for CAD is the graphics card. When designing in SolidWorks, we spend all day long zooming, panning, and rotating and interrogating our models. All of this is driven by the graphics card. A professional graphics card may add slightly to the cost, but these are the only supported cards for SolidWorks, CATIA, and many other professional applications. Developers from Nvidia work closely together with software developers to ensure performance, stability, and feature compatibility. If you have a non-supported card, your software of choice may run, however, you are more likely to experience more issues with performance, stability, and maybe lack certain features. This also means that our support team would need to replicate any issue on a supported system before we can get assistance from the developers to resolve it. We also recently tested GeForce gaming cards in SolidWorks, which are not supported, and with medium-sized assemblies with a few thousand parts, we saw performance up to 10 times slower, plus various lacking features, glitches in just a few minutes of use, making working pretty painful. While cash-strapped students working on small datasets may get by without, those using the tools professionally will see the payback in guaranteed feature support, stability, and performance. We recommend the latest Nvidia RTX Professional range with the Nvidia RTX A1000 for those mostly focused on CAD work, and the Nvidia RTX A2000 and above for those dealing with more complex datasets, advanced workflows such as visualization, 3D scanning. For SolidWorks Visualize and many third-party rendering applications such as KeyShot, although they can run in a CPU mode, graphics cards are becoming the key driver of increased performance for visualization applications. Comparing a 16-core CPU to a mid-range GPU, we saw over 20 times performance improvements. So for those using Visualize extensively, we currently recommend the Nvidia RTX A4000 16GB in a desktop or an A3000 12GB mobile graphics card or above. These have sufficient power and dedicated memory for most use cases, and with the GPU rendering, the dedicated graphics memory is crucial as the scene must fit with inside the graphics card's memory limits. This is one area where desktops can offer a significant upgrade over laptops due to the increased space for components with higher power limits. So while laptops are available with a maximum of 16GB of graphics memory, desktops top out with the RTX A6000 48GB, which adds more cores as well as memory. However, with costs approximately 4 times more, the best value for money option is the RTX A4000 16GB. The return on investment can be very quick if you're getting the results back that much quicker or are able to render scenes you previously may have had to outsource. To summarise, for the vast majority of CAD and CAE tools, we recommend workstations featuring the latest Intel Core CPUs, 32 to 64GB of RAM, and an Nvidia Professional graphics card with at least 4GB of dedicated graphics memory. We have a range of pre-configured systems tailored to various applications which will scale up those components, making it easy for you, and we can also help with advice or custom specifications as needed. It's also worth noting that for the most common workflows, laptops are now almost as fast as desktops, with only about a 10 to 20% advantage for desktops in typical CAD workflows. A recommended replacement cycle is between 3 to 5 years to get a good return on investment whilst also prioritizing engineering time, ensuring users have the best hardware to allow them to deliver results without delays. We hope you found this useful, and if so, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and make sure you check out the link in the description below for our up-to-date pre-built machine specs.